Hello everybody, this is Jesse from Napco Tech Support. And today in this brief video tech tip, I'm gonna go over how to wire inputs 2 and or 3 for supervised fire alarm and trouble on your Napco StarLink fire radio. That's a fairly simple process, so let's get started. First, we're gonna wanna ensure that jumpers 4 and 5 are installed on the X5 block. This comes from the factory this way, so this should have not been removed. Next, we're gonna wanna take our 9 SLE 10K HARN, two of which are included with your Napco StarLink fire radio. Now, using this harness wired to one of the inputs, this is gonna allow us to have two trips out of one input on the radio, because this harness has two built-in 10K resistors, one in series and one in parallel. Now, a normal reading for this harness is gonna be about 4.9K, which the radio is gonna read as all normal. Just finish wiring this up. Now, this harness needs to be installed in the fire alarm control panel for supervision purposes, but today for the demonstration, I'm going to wire it directly to the radio. Now we're going to take the red, either red, it doesn't matter which one, and the black, that's going to get wired to a normally open fire alarm relay. So when the fire alarm panel goes into alarm, the relay will short the input, and you'll see the transmit light go on, sending a fire alarm signal to central station. Once the alarm has been reset, the input will open back up, again causing the radio to send a restore on the fire alarm to central station. Next, we're going to take the other red and the blue, and that's going to get wired to a normally closed trouble relay, fire alarm panel trouble relay. Now, be careful. Most of these trouble relays on the fire alarm control panels are fail safe. So you're gonna have to wire it in opposite state. So in a trouble condition, the fire alarm panel will open up this input, changing the resistance now on the harness to 10K, which the radio will recognize as a fire alarm panel trouble and cause a signal to be sent to central station. Same when the trouble condition has been restored, we'll simulate this input closing back up, and you can see the radio sending a restore. Now this also, in opposed to a complete open or cut wire, that's also going to cause the radio to send a trouble signal to the central station, but in this instance it's going to activate the trouble output PGM1 on the radio, which would put your fire alarm control panel into a trouble condition for a cut wire. And we'll just restore this back up. Now, these same basic steps can be used if you needed additional signals, such as supervisory or CO alarm, to input number 3 using the same basic concept. One open, one short. Now, just for a brief review, we went over how to wire our 9 SLE 10K HARN to inputs 2 and or 3 on our Napco StarLink fire radio. If you have any additional questions, you can always reach out to us at tech support or check out our technical library at www.tech.napcosecurity.com. Thank you all so much for watching today.